Hello friends, welcome to this video on triangles. In the previous video, we discussed some criteria of congruence of triangles. Today, using these, we will discuss some properties of a triangle. Especially those triangles that have two equal sides. Friends, in the previous session we have learned that a triangle with two equal sides is called an isosceles triangle. Let us construct an isosceles triangle XYZ with sides XY and XZ equal to 6 cm. Friends, can we tell something about the angles of this triangle? With the help of a protractor, let's find the measure of all the angles of this triangle. Now you can see that the measure of angle Y and angle Z is equal, and both these angles are opposite to the equal sides. Pause the video to repeat this activity for other isosceles triangles. And now, you will come to the conclusion that for each isosceles triangle, angles that are opposite to the equal sides are equal. We can write this as a theorem in the following manner. Angles opposite to the equal sides of an isosceles triangle are equal. This is an important result. This can be proved by several methods. With the help of this statement, let us construct another triangle. Triangle PQR is an isosceles triangle. It's given that side PQ is equal to side PR. This has been given to us, and we have to prove that angle Q is equal to angle R. Let's look at its argument. Draw the bisector of angle P, which intersects the side QR at point T. Now, look at triangles QPT and RPT. It's given that side QP and side RP are equal. By construction, PT is the bisector of angle QPR. Therefore, angle QPT and angle RPT will be equal. And side PT is the common side for both the triangles. Look at equations 1, 2 and 3. We can say that both these triangles are congruent according to the side angle side, that is, the SAS congruence rule. We know that the corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal. Therefore, angle Q and angle R will be equal. Friends, we can prove these two triangles congruent by some other methods also. For example, if we take the midpoint of side QR as T and draw a line PT. Now we can see that in both triangles, all three sides are equal. Therefore, according to the SSS congruence rule, these two triangles will be congruent. And the corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal. Therefore, angle Q and angle R will also be equal. Is the converse also true? So, if two angles of any triangle are equal, can we conclude that the sides opposite them are also equal? Let's see. Let's take a triangle XYZ, in which angle XYZ and angle XZY are equal. Now we have to prove that the opposite sides are equal. Let's move ahead and prove this. Here, draw the bisector of angle YXZ and let it intersect YZ at O. Now look at triangle XYO and triangle XZO. It's given that these two angles are equal. Here we can write angle XYZ as XYO and angle XZY as XZO. Therefore, these will also be equal. And we constructed XO, which is the bisector of angle YXZ. Therefore, angle YXO and angle ZXO will be equal. Side XO is the common side. From equations 1, 2 and 3, we can say that by the AAS congruence rule, these two triangles are congruent. And we know that the corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal. Therefore, side XY and side XZ are equal. Therefore, we can say that the converse of the theorem is also true. That is, the sides opposite to the equal angles of a triangle are equal. You can also try to prove it by any other method. So, that's it for today. In this session, we discussed some properties of triangles. Let's meet in the next video related to the same with a few questions. Thank you.